Hello and welcome to Jacinto 7 training on Processor SDK for automotive applications. Processor SDK contains various software components which will allow you to develop and deploy your applications onto Jacinto 7 family of SoCs. My name is Kedar and I am the software architect of Processor SDK. Let's look at how to download and install the different Linux and RTOS SDK. To download the Linux SDK, go to the Processor SDK Linux Automotive Product Download page. This page hosts the Linux SDK installer and additional tools and collateral. You need to download the installer binary file as shown here. You can also browse the user guide online by going to the user guide homepage as shown here. Similarly, to download the RTOS SDK, go to the Processor SDK RTOS Automotive Product Download page. This page hosts the RTOS SDK installer and additional tools and collateral. You need to download the SDK installer tar file as shown here. To run the deep learning demos, you need to also download the demo input dataset tar file as shown here. And you can also browse the user guide online by going to the user guide homepage as shown here. Once again, Linux and RTOS SDK complement each other, and it's very important that you download and install both Linux and RTOS SDKs. Next, we will install the Linux and RTOS SDK. Do note that you need to do these steps on a Linux Ubuntu 64-bit machine. Ubuntu 18.04 with 100 GB of disk space is recommended. Virtual machine like VirtualBox or VMware running Ubuntu can also be used. To install Linux SDK, create a folder to install the SDK. Any folder is fine. Install the SDK as shown here. Follow the on-screen steps and install in the newly created folder. To get started, open the user guide homepage as shown here in a web browser. Next, let's see how to navigate to important portions of the Linux SDK user guide. All Linux SDK documentation can be reached starting from this homepage. To get started, see the Quick Start Guide. For details about different Linux SDK components like U-boot, kernel, go to Foundational Components. For details about EVM setup and additional useful tips and developer notes, go to How-to Guides. Next, we install RTOS SDK. Once again, do note that you need to do these steps on a Linux Ubuntu 64-bit machine. To install RTOS SDK, create a folder to install the SDK. Any folder is fine. Install the SDK as shown over here. And to get started, open the user guide homepage as shown here in a web browser. Now let's see how to navigate to important portions of the RTOS SDK user guide. All RTOS SDK documentation can be reached starting from this homepage. To get started, see the Getting Started. For details about different RTOS SDK components like SysBIOS, DIDL, OpenVX, go to SDK Components. For details about EVM setup, see EVM setup. And for additional useful tips and developer notes, go to Developer Notes section.
Thank you for watching this training. For more information, refer to the links shown. For questions about this training, go to the Processor Forums at ede.ti.com.